This video shows how to install PS2 Linux on the hard disk. For installing Linux on the hard disk, you need to enter commands in the program Xterm. The menu can be opened with the square button, and you can select the menu entry Xterm with the circle button. Enter the su command to get root access. Then start the PS2 FDisk program, but don't forget the version number behind the program name because there is a second version installed. The p command prints the current partition table. The end command creates a new partition. We need to create a swap partition. Choose 128 megabytes for the size. We also need to create a second partition. This will store the Linux root file system. Choose the maximum size. The w command will store the partition table on the hard disk and leave the program. We need to format the swap partition with the mkswap command. The next command will format the second partition. This creates an X2 file system. We need to mount the file system with the mount command. This enables access to the files in the file system. Now we can copy all files from the PS2 Live DVD to the new partition. The -a parameter is important because it preserves the access rights. This command takes a while. I cut the video because I think you do not want to wait. Now we change the current directory to the new file system. Because we want to change something, first we copy the fstub.org file. This file contains entries what is mounted at startup. We need to run the vi command. This is an editor. The X key deletes characters. You need to press it several times. The I key changes to insert mode. You can insert the first partition. Press escape to leave the insert mode. Press C and then W to change the word. We need to change UnionFS to the second partition. We need also to change the file system type. Press CW again and don't forget to press escape. Press D twice to delete a line and press colon WQ to save the file and leave the editor. We need also to configure the video mode. The video mode is auto-detected by kernel loader. This is stored in the etc x mode file. We need to copy this file to the new file system. On my system, this file contains PAL. Now we change the directory because we want to unmount the file system because everything is finished now. The exit command closes the window and we can shut down the PS2. I copied the VM Linux file from the PS2 live DVD to an USB memory stick. You will also need to do it. This is needed to start Linux from the hard disk. You can also store the file on the memory card if you want. Let's start kernel loader. First, you need to restore the defaults. Press enter. Then select the kernel. I have stored it on the USB memory stick. You can also store it on the memory card. Select VM Linux. Disable the RAM file system. Go to the configuration menu and select the second partition. Then you can store the configuration in the file menu. Now boot the current config. This loads the kernel from the USB memory device. Now it's waiting for the hard disk. The Linux kernel is started. The second partition is mounted and the swap partition is activated. It's now running from the hard disk. The X server is started and you can use the system. Thanks for watching.